All right, we know him from the Twilight saga, a ton of other work. Now he's in a new movie called The Wall of Mexico. Deep in the heart of Texas, we find Jackson Rathbone. Jackson, good morning to you.
Good morning. Thanks so much for having me. I'm glad we can connect.
Really, really happy to have you. Let me ask you this. Spooky time of year, Halloween, etc. Is this a good time to revisit the Twilight franchise? Do you ever go back and rewatch it?
You know, my kids are getting to the age where my wife says that we might have to kind of bust out the old fangs and get into some Twilight movies. I still think they're a little bit of a ways away. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see. I do get a lot of people hitting me up on Instagram saying that it's flooding the TV again.
Let me ask you this. How old are your kids?
I got an 8-year-old and a 4-year-old girl, and then my baby's a baby, so he's just little.
All right. With the 8-year-old and the 4-year-old, are they aware of what daddy does just generally?
Kind of. It's kind of a weird sense of aware, right? So they know dad's an actor. My son has been to set with me a few times, actually, so he really gets it. My daughter just thinks I'm a big toy, so, all right. Which is pretty much true.
Fair enough. Let's talk about The Wall of Mexico.
Yes,
some might suggest
you.
Just the phrase "The Wall of Mexico" indicates there's political overtones to this movie. Is that correct?
There are political overtones, but it is a satire. The film is deeply imbued with the sense of comedy, and we got some amazing performances from Alex Meneses, from Isai Morales, and from Xander Berkeley, from the two young leads that play the girls. And I had a great time playing basically Dopey Don, essentially, in this film. It's a great movie. It can be incendiary looking at the title, The Wall of Mexico, right? But it's really about the walls that we put up in our lives. This film is about this very wealthy Mexican-American family that hires this young white gardener, essentially me, to build a wall around their property to keep the locals out. Now, there's a lot of other, you know, different levels to it, but it's really about the walls between rich and poor, between men and women, and just the walls we even put up between our families.
I tell you what, well described. Here's a clip. Take a look.
Thanks.
Everyone, the well's at 30%.
We just want to know if anyone has seen anything.
What's the deal with the water?
They sell it. It has a flavor, too. Unusual.
People in town are freaks about it.
You guys partying tonight?
Go, 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 go.
It's evident what needs to be done.
Our culture is turning inwards and devouring itself.
We need fresh blood.
You work in Mexico? They let you drink the water?
Man, is that some sort of like local racist joke?
All right, there's a lot going on there. That was more of a trailer than a specific clip. But that's interesting because, again, that title is a juxtaposition from what you think it would be about.
Yeah, man, I appreciate you noticing that. I think what is interesting about this film is all the juxtapositions, right? And there's also, in this trailer, as you can see, there's a lot happening with what is going on with the Aristas family's water and the water that they keep on their property. Without giving too much away, there might be some magical properties to it.
Oh, all right. Fair enough. Last thing, Jackson, tilt your head down. I got to read your cap.
Yeah, man, check this out. You see this?
Birth, movies, death. Very good. All right.
This is from the Alamo Draft House, which is a Texas institution. It is a movie theater that, you know, I very much hope that we can keep alive. It's a really weird time for all of us. I know we're all trying to stick together and do our best. I really hope we can keep certain cultural institutions alive, especially the movie theaters. It's very important to me. Alamo Draft House is one of my favorite places in the world. So hopefully we all get through this together and we keep our culture alive.
Jackson, well said. We'll point out Alamo Draft House has a terrific outlet in downtown Los Angeles. Wall of Mexico is now available on demand from Dark Star Pictures. Omari Hardwick on the way in our 9 o'clock hour. Morning news continues here. We'll be right back.